गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द टॉपिक ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ. अर्लियर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अबाउट वेजिटेशन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, अबाउट वाइल्ड लाइफ वी हैव स्टडीड दैट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टुक सो मेनी स्टेप्स टू कंजर्व द वाइल्ड लाइफ. टुडे वी विल स्टडी दैट व्हाट वर दोज स्टेप्स. सो नंबर वन, हंटिंग एंड पोचिंग ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स हैव बीन बैंड. So people cannot hunt wild animals and birds. That is banned. Killing of wildlife is a punishable offense. If anyone kills any of the wildlife, whether they are birds, whether they are animals, they will be and you know they will get punishment. National parks and wildlife, that punishment can be sentenced in prison or that can be a fine also. National parks and wildlife sanctuaries are being set up in different parts of the world. At present, India has 103 national parks and 528 wildlife sanctuaries. This data must be clear in your mind. Now we will study that what are national parks. A national park is a well-defined area for the protection of wildlife. So you know, to protect the wildlife, some area is defined. कि इस area को बिल्कुल conserve करके हमने रखा हुआ है यहाँ wildlife बचाने के लिए. Visitors can only visit the park, like Jim Corbett National Park. If any one of you have been there, that park, that is a national park, that is a well-defined area. Visitors can visit there. No one has a right to use any forest product. So you cannot use any forest product there. That is totally reserved. Collection of firewood, timber from any part of the forest is totally prohibited. You know, national park में जो rules regulations होते हैं ना, ज़्यादा strictness होती है उसमें. No one can collect firewood or timber from any part of the forest. बिल्कुल ban है. Grand Canyon National Park of USA is declared as a World Heritage Site by the UNESCO. So UNESCO की यहाँ पर full form भी दी है. You must know that United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. So students, now we have Wildlife Sanctuary. It is a declared protected area in which limited human activities are permitted. A wildlife sanctuary जो है वो थोड़ी सी liberations है वहाँ पर कि limited human activities हो सकते हैं. यहाँ पर तो देखो बिल्कुल वो है ना, strictness. Hunting of animals and cutting of trees are banned. यहाँ पर भी hunting and cutting of trees is totally banned. People can collect firewood, timber and medicinal herbs. सो यहाँ परमिशन है दैट दे कैन कलेक्ट फायरवुड, टिम्बर एंड मेडिसिनल हर्ब्स, जो मेडिसिंस में काम आती हैं हर्ब्स, इन अ मॉडरेट अमाउंट विच कैन बी यूज फॉर रिसर्च एंड एजुकेशनल पर्पजेज. बट दैट ऑल्सो इन मॉडरेट अकाउंट. ऐसा नहीं है कि पूरा का पूरा बल्क में ही ले जा रहे हैं. बट दैट कैन बी यूज इन एजुकेशनल रिसर्च एंड अदर एजुकेशनल पर्पजेज. The UNESCO has selected Manas Wildlife Sanctuary of India as a World Heritage Site. ठीक है students? Now do you know? In India, Wildlife Protection Act of 1972 prohibits poaching, hunting and trade of wildlife. आपने अपनी बुक के सारे do you know को अच्छे से study करना है, और जो ऐसे informative हैं वो तो पक्का आने चाहिए आपको. In 1973, Project Tiger was launched in India with the aim of conserving tigers. Initially, 9 tiger reserves were set up, which expanded to 39 tiger reserves in 2010. So, when this Project Tiger was started, at that time, you know, in the beginning, only 9 tiger reserves were there. But afterwards, as the project grew up, 39 tiger reserves were there in 2010. Jim Corbett National Park of Uttarakhand is famous tiger reserves of India. It's a well-known national park and a very beautiful one. Students, these are the keywords. You are supposed to read them by your own. And now we will do the exercise. Which term, these are the, tick the correct option. Which term is used for the plant community which grows without human interference? So that is natural vegetation. Which vegetation grows in hot and humid regions of the world? That is tropical evergreen forest. The most common trees of tropical deciduous forest are, that is sal and teak. Trees of Mediterranean forest are आर हैव स्पाइनी एंड, यहाँ आर नहीं आएगा, हैव स्पाइनी एंड वैक्सी लीव्स. द एरिया अंडर फॉरेस्ट इज डिप्लीटिंग ड्यू टू ह्यूमन इंटरफेरेंस. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. द असेंबलेज ऑफ प्लांट स्पीशीज इन एन एनवायरमेंट इज नोन एज नेचुरल वेजिटेशन. डैश एंड डैश आर टू इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स फॉर द प्लांट ग्रोथ, दैट इज टेम्परेचर एंड रेनफॉल. ह्यूमस हेल्प्स टू मेंटेन डैश ऑफ द सॉयल. द आंसर इज फर्टिलिटी. हार्डवुड ट्रीज हैव ब्रॉड लीव्स टू परमिट डैश सरप्लस मॉइस्चर. ट्रांसपीरेशन. टीक इज द कमर्शियली इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्री ऑफ डैश फॉरेस्ट, दैट इज डेसीड्यूअस फॉरेस्ट. राइट अ टेक्निकल टर्म और एन अप्रोप्रिएट वर्ड फॉर ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. The forests which do not shed all their leaves at the same time, they are known as tropical evergreen forest. In this forest, summers are dry and moderate rain falls in winter. They are Mediterranean forest. Conical shaped trees are common in these forests, temperate softwood forests. The act or process of creating new forest by planting saplings, that is afforestation. The temperate softwood forest found in the southern slopes of Himalayas, they are known as mountain forests. So students, now we will take up the question answer D1. Why are the tropical rainforest known as evergreen forest? So the answer is, you can write the answer. In tropical rainforests, all the trees in tropical rainforests, all the trees do not shed their leaves at the same time. So it seems that they are evergreen. Why do the tropical deciduous forests shed their leaves during the summer season? So the answer is, the tropical deciduous forests shed their leaves during the summer season to maintain moisture. Name two such trees. Kaun se hain? You will write two such trees are, number one sal, number one, number two teak. Now students, question number 3. Write any three characteristic features of the trees found in Mediterranean forests. So number one, trees of Mediterranean forest have spiny and waxy leaves. Point number 2. In this forest, summers are dry. ये वाला point तो रहने दो, summers are dry वाला. Second point लिखो. Trees have thick bark. Point number 3. Trees of these forests are widely scattered. Distinguish between a national park and a wildlife sanctuary. So here you will put a line, national park or wildlife sanctuary. ठीक है, proper आपको ऐसा होना चाहिए लिखा हुआ. और ये तो मैंने short में लिखा है, आपको full form में लिखना है. So first point, a national park is a well-defined area for the protection of wildlife. Point number one, it is a declared protected area in which limited human activities are permitted. दोनों के one point हो गए. Next, point number two, collection of firewood, timber from any part of the forest is totally prohibited. Point number two, national park का. पॉइंट नंबर टू, यहाँ पे पीपल कैन कलेक्ट फायरवुड टिम्बल एंड मेडिसिनल हर्ब्स इन मॉडरेट अमाउंट. बस यहाँ तक. ओके, ये हो गया पॉइंट नंबर टू. पॉइंट नंबर थ्री, एग्जाम्पल सिर्फ आपने ये लिखना है एग्जाम्पल, ग्रैंड कैनियन नेशनल पार्क ऑफ, बस यहाँ तक, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल। एंड देन यहाँ पे एग्जाम्पल मानस वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी। सो स्टूडेंट्स, अप टू हेयर ओनली वी विल स्टडी टूडे, एंड इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल टेक अप दीज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑल्सो। सो स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे। आई होप यू ऑल विल कंप्लीट योर वर्क प्रॉपरली इन योर नोटबुक। थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स, हैव अ नाइस डे।